video after the bell, hitting the finish line for the year. And I'm hitting the finish line of a school 5K. What, no medal? It's time to play Holiday or Not a Day, May Edition. The whole goal of this game is to figure out, is this an actual holiday, a day that somebody has said is important and put it on a calendar, or is it not? Here's the first one. Geek Pride Day. Is there such a thing as Geek Pride Day, and is it in May? What do you think? The answer is yes. May 25th, if you're a geek, have pride that day. The next one, Eat Whatever You Want Day. I feel like this has been the entire quarantine deal, right? But is it actually a day or not? The answer, yes, May 11th is that holiday. How about this? Alien Abduction Awareness Week. Is there an Is this a week? The answer is no, it's not. For a minute, I think you all thought I got taken over by an alien. How about this? Insult Your Boss Day. Wow, that's mean. Savage. Is this true, though? The answer, no. It's never a good day to insult your boss. How about this? National Chicken Dance Day. If this is not a day, it should be. Here we go. Is it? Yes, May 14th. Be sure you celebrate by dancing outside the chicken dance. National Stuttering Awareness Week. Is this an actual holiday that's celebrated in May? Yes, the second full week of May. How about this? World Naked Gardening Day. Please do not try this at home. The answer to whether this is a day or not in May? Oh my goodness, it is. May 6th. I hope none of you celebrated. How about this? Your Mama Joke Day. Is there a day celebrating your mama jokes? No, there's not. Always be nice to your mama. Especially on Mother's Day. How about this? Make an Excuse Day. Some of you are like, I celebrate this every day. The answer to this is no, never a good day to celebrate an excuse. How about this? Root Canal Appreciation Day. Wow. Is it celebrated or May or not? Yes, it is. May 11th, Root Canal Appreciation Day. Dentists everywhere having a party. And our last one. When is International Roller Derby Day? Yes, there is a thing. It's in May. There's no closest wins on this, but we just want to see maybe if you can guess when it would be. And the answer is May the 5th. Go outside with your roller skates, knock some people over, and celebrate. When is International Roller Derby Day? That's Holiday or Not a Day. Thank you for playing. Hey, everybody. We are here with some fantastic people. You probably recognize them. They're your adult leaders for After the Bell. Say hey, everybody.
Hello.
Hey.
All right. If you don't know them, on your screen we have Mrs. Thompson from BMS. We have Mrs. Voris from BMS. They both will be there next year, by the way. We have Mrs. Jones from OMS and BNL. You'll see her there, eighth graders, down the road too. And we have Mr. Fields from Shoswick Middle School, who will be at BMS next year. So these are great people. Get to know them. They'll be around. You'll get to see them there next year. Hopefully, we'll start on time and everything will be normal. We'll see. We don't know.
But they're here today, and they're going to share with you some quarantine stories. That's what we're going to call this. And we're just going to talk about some things that have been happening to us over the last couple months that you haven't seen us, or maybe you haven't seen us much. And just maybe some things we've learned and some things we've experienced, and maybe that'll help you guys out a little bit. So, adults, are you ready to go? Okay, first one. What has been the biggest challenge for you during this quarantine?
I say for me, the biggest challenge has been not being able to just go and do whatever I want, whenever I want. If I think, oh, I need that, well, I can't go get that. So maybe being a little bit more prepared for life in general.
Yeah. Mrs. Jones.
Trying to stick to any kind of schedule and not just stay up late and sleep in late like my college kid.
Yeah. Mrs. Voris?
For me, it was getting used to going back to the grocery store with the whole new system and sanitizing everything as I went and as I picked up and wearing a mask. And so, yeah, that was really different.
All right. Mr. Fields?
I think just not being able to be around people very often. It's very frustrating to just be stuck at home and you can't go and hang out with people. Hardly saw my parents in this time at all. Friends, nothing, you know, we're not at church. It's just very difficult not to be able to be around people. I'm pretty social, so.
Okay, our second question is, what has been your biggest joy during this time?
I think all of the extra family time. We live such a hurried life where we're going from one thing to the next, and just being able to slow down and be together has been so fun.
Yeah. Mrs. Jones?
Same here, just time with the guys and time to rest.
Yeah. Mrs. Voris?
I was going to say the same thing. I have loved being with my family. We laugh a lot around here, and I found myself thinking, you know, it's like, that wouldn't have happened if we weren't quarantined, or some, you know, something will happen or be silly. And I also have appreciated the fact that I can go, I check on my parents, and I've been able to do that more frequently. And I've been thankful for that. It's hard when I'm teaching to also then check on my parents, but we've stayed away from each other, but I've been buying her groceries. And so I've been thankful for that.
Mr. Fields?
4 for 4, same thing. My family, been watching my daughter. She'll be 2 in less than 2 months. And my wife's working from home. And so she normally works in Bloomington, and that's an hour and a half of driving that, you know, is she's here when she gets off, she's done. And if I need her for something, and if I need a break, she's there, she can stop what she's doing. And it's been wonderful to be with family and the extra time we've had together. So.
The next question is, what is something you've learned to do during this time?
My family has learned to play disc golf. We have bought all the discs on Amazon. We live about 3 miles from Otis Park, and we are down there playing disc golf all the time. Both of my boys and my husband get better every time, and I have only gotten worse. Can't throw a frisbee.
Mrs. Jones?
Not really something new, just getting back to old things, back to gardening, back to doing my cross stitch and stuff.
Okay. Mrs. Voris?
So I'm going to cheat. I actually have 2 things. My first thing is I finally mastered my mother's recipe for homemade crescent rolls. So I was very excited about that. But the second thing, because this is actually brand new, I learned my first scale on the bass guitar. So
great.
That was a huge accomplishment for me.
All right. Mr. Fields.
Well, as I mentioned in the last question, I've been with my daughter. I'm learning more and more patience with my daughter. She's definitely acting like a two-year-old toddler. I'm not used to working with toddlers and having to just have a different approach when I'm trying to teach her something, or when we're, you know, coming up with different ideas on what we can play, what we can do. So I've learned a lot. It's a grind some days, but it's been quite a joy. But yeah, just more patience, I guess, with dealing with my daughter.
That'll do it. Now, what is something you've learned from God during this time?
There's a verse in Exodus that says, "The Lord will fight for you. You need only be still." And I'm not a very still person. I'm a fixer and a doer. And this has kind of been a forced stillness. And it's been really good for my relationship with God.
Ms. Jones?
Just the importance of rest and of not letting myself spiral out when things get crazy and just go to God first instead of spiraling out and venting and things.
Okay. For me, it's been that He's always with us no matter what we're going through or what's happening, and that you can find Him through it all. There's been so many times where I've thought, I'm not sure that blessing would have happened if we had not been quarantined. And even though we're going through a tough time, He's there with us through that.
Mm-hmm. The first part is actually what Amy said, that, you know, God's with us in the good times. He's with us in the rough times, but that He's still working and He's still moving in our lives. And I've just been, the last week, I've just been thinking about, you know, we have to listen to God. He'll speak to us. We have to listen to, who want to do something good, something positive. We have to listen and be open to that. Because he'll speak to us, but we have to be open to that and listen. And like one of you said, be still. Then we'll get direction on what we should be doing.
And the last thing, we wanted to give everybody a chance to say something to you, all the viewers, something they'd like to tell you. So here we go.
This is something new for all of us, and you guys are doing such a fantastic job at something that no one has any experience with. I can't imagine being a teenager and experiencing this, but so many of you with your schoolwork, how you're helping your family, you're just doing awesome. So keep up the good work.
Hey guys, we're going to be okay. I know it's weird. I know it's crazy. We don't know what we're doing. None of us in this, but it's going to be okay. God knows what's going on and we're all going to be fine.
So I have a verse from Joshua chapter 1, verse 9, and it kind of harkens back to what God has kind of shown me through this. But it says to be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened or dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. So eighth graders, if you're going on out to the high school, God's going to be with you. He's with us in quarantine and with our families. If you're in seventh grade and we get to see you again, we can't wait to see you next year. And that no matter where you are or where we end up going, God will be with us.
Hello, students. I hope that you guys, just a couple things I want to reflect on, a couple things. I hope that you're getting closer with your family with this extended time off. I hope that, you know, you use this time to study God's word, to pray more, to reflect on what you want to be. And hope, my prayer is that you'll grow in your faith in Jesus and all that. And hope that you'll be excited to come back to school. I know I am when we get back to school. It's been an extended break, so miss you all, and hope, like I said, hope you all have a good summer.
All right. Thank you all for being here. It's good to see you all again, and I know that everybody will be glad to see you.
We're glad our volunteers joined us today. Good to see them, and you can see them again next week. We are having actual live After the Bells next week, and we want you to be a part of that. You can see on the screen, OMS is going to meet on Monday, BMS on Tuesday, SMS on Thursday, 3:30 on Zoom. We invite you to be a part of that. I'm going to, again, going to put my number at the bottom of the screen. That is how you can get the link. All you have to do is text me, tell me who you are, and I will send you the link, and you can come on there and join us, just like today with the volunteers. You saw how we did it. And we'll get on there. We'll have a good time. We'll play some games. Maybe have a video, watch some, you know, just watch each other and say, hey. I mean, it's our chance to close out the year. It is our last and final After the Bell of the year, and we want you to be a part of it. So if you go to those schools, you've been a part of this, please join us those days, because we'd love to see you there. Again, reminder, this summer we're going to have videos. There'll be short stories, I believe. Still putting that together. But subscribe to this channel, and you will get those. You'll get alerts. They will tell you when those are up, and I'll be putting those out every week coming in June. Guys, it's time to go. It's our final one. I'm glad you guys joined us for this, and we're a part of this. It's been different. Been a different year, but we hope that we've been able to keep things going, and we're glad that you've been a part of After the Bell this year. Have an awesome summer, and we hope to see you this fall in person.
Renegade. Go. Here we go. Got one. Go. Go. Oh.